बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, लेट्स मेक अ रिव्यू व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर। वी डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर द एफर्ट मेटलाइजेशन, देन स्टार्टेड लेट्स देन व्हाट वी एज वी वर गिवन दैट द वी नीड टू मेक द फूड मेटलाइजेशन फॉर द लेट मी चेंज द कलर यस फूड मेटलाइजेशन फॉर द क्यूब एग्रीगेशन। So what are the cuboids? If you have the three dimension A, B, C, three dimension are there. These are the cuboids A, B, C, A, B, B, C, C, A, A, B, C, and final. These are the cuboids. Then if you were given the data size for the data size for the array as A, B, and C as the 40, 400, and 4000. It means the size of the array for A is 40, size for the B is 400, size for the C is 4000. Obviously, these can obviously if you need to fit up these data size cannot be fit for the single cube. For the single cube, it means we require some chunking mechanism. If we require chunking, it means make into the group. Then we can easily fit them if we will divide all of them with the four. All of them. With the 4 as 40 divided by 4 is equal to 10. The chunk size for the A is 10. The chunk size for the B is 400 divided by 4 is equal to 100. Chunk size for the C is 1000. For the examination point of view and for the numerical, you are not concerned about the what will be the how can we divide and something else. The chunk size will be given to you. The data size along with the chunk size will be given to you. What we required. So moreover, as we saw that in the previous lecture, that the base on the traversing order to scan the cuboids, the number of total calculation combination will be different. Number of combination, for example, if you will make this, if you example is if you make the let me go to previous line. Yes, for example, if you go to the, this order 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, if you go to this order, then number of calculation computation required will different. Moreover, if you will go with this order 1 1 5 9, then this the number of calculation will be different. This is so this this is the basic idea about the aggregation. If I will go for the AB 1 2 3 4 5, it means first I am going towards the A. Suppose I am going, so I need to calculate the computation for 1 2 3 4 5. First scan this one, then two, then three, etc. Then this is the most frequently be changing A. Then I will go 5 5, means the second one is the changing is B, then C dimension. It what is the combination A B A C N? Then what will the combination first most frequently be changing as A, then B, then C. What will be the combination A B A C and B C? All of the three faces will be all of the three faces they are here. Yes. So now let's talk about how do we compute. Yes, what we require, we need to make the calculation. If the scanning order is from 1 to 64, then AB, AC, and BC. In order to compute for this traversing order, it consists of three part. One part is for the whole data sizes. Second part is one row of plane. Third part is consists of the chunk of the plane, full plane, one row of plane, and the chunk only. For the what a full plane means, all the data size of A and B. What's data size of A is 40, data size of B is 400. What about AC? One row, only one row means AB. One row is full data size of A, the chunk of C. That represent the one row of AC. What about the third part? Third part consists of the chunk of both B and C. The chunk of B and chunk of C. The total computation calculation is equal to 156,000. Moreover, the traversing order is 1 17 33, etc. Then what will be the total number of calculation? Then what will be the total number of calculation as? Let me give you then let me for yes come back to the previous one. What we are trying to do, 1 17 31, 171 is the behind, 17 is behind of 1. Then what we require, first we will go to C. Then, because the traversing order is 1, 17. 17 is behind of C. Then 31, 31 is behind of C. Then C, then A, then B. What will be the combination? CA, CB, and AB. No. 117.33. Let me check it again. No. Wrong. It is wrong. It is yes. First we are 117.33. Then first we are going to C, then B, then A. Okay. Then the combination is C, B, A. These are the combination. C B C A and B A. C B C and B A. Let me yes. For the traversing 117.33.49, then we will go for the B. Then as I just mentioned that for BC, CA, and AB. So it means for the first part to for this traversing order for the first part is equal to the data size of for the plane BC is data size full data size of B full data size of C. Then what about the CA? In the CA here we have the chunk of A multiplied by the one row of CA, chunk of A multiplied by full data size of C. Third part is equal to both of them chunking. For this plane, both of them the chunk for A and chunk of B, and total number of calculations is 1,641. It means by just changing the traversing order, total number of calculations will be different. These are the basic idea what we have discussed in the previous. Today we will discuss about something new. Today we will discuss about the as we recall, first we talk about the partial metallization, then we discuss partial metallization, then we discuss about the full metallization. Now come to the another important third category is the no metallization. In the no metallization, what we are trying to do, no metallization indexing of the OLAP or bitmap indexing. As if we are familiar, a bit is consist of only two state, either 0 or 1. Either 0 or 1. In other words, we can apply this concept either we can set the value of the data or the field or as the set for 1 or 0 means not set. This will be clear vector indexing, this will be clear when I solve the numerical. So the point is here, this type of metallization is very this is effective for the case if you have a low number of cardinality. Let's be checking. First, what is indexing? Indexing is a data structure technique to efficiently retrieve the record from the database file based on the attribute on which the indexing has been done. Moreover, let's see, and in fact, bitmap indexing, it is an effective indexing technique for attribute with low cardinality value. Here one of the important feature is this technique is only effective for the case if you have a low cardinality. What is the low cardinality? Low cardinality means uniqueness of the data value contained in the particular column attribute of the database. For example, I have the database for 1 million record. I need to divide this by 1 million record in term of male and female. So I have only either the record belongs to the person is the male or female. So in other words, suppose I want to make the this record in term of age. In term of age, one of the possibility that I enter the value 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, then I have high number of different values. On the other hand, I can set the values in terms of kids, youth, and old. So how many cardinality values do I have? Either the kids, either the youth, or either the old. The cardinality value is 3. The same you can apply. Suppose we want to in the right now the kingdom they are facing the problem for the coronavirus, and they want to divide the divided data, full database, in terms of the either the person has the coronavirus or does not have. It means zero and one. So these are represent the cardinality means uniqueness. Either the person has the corona, does not have the corona. These are the uniqueness. So in other words, because each of the value in the column has a bit vector. Each value of the column, this for this column, must have the bit vector value. So bit vector. We can set the bit. What is the property of the bit? The bit has the only two state, 0 and 1. 0 can be represented 0 and 1, 2 and 4, etc. 0 can be represented for no. 1 can be represented as a set to set the value. So the length of the bit vector represent the number of record in the base table. This will be clear when I go to the next slide. What is the concept of what is the length of the bit vector? For example, as I just mentioned about the give the example for the population, in terms of population, kids, youth and old, what is the length of the bit vector is 3. Moreover, let me talk about the dimension of the kingdom. Kingdom of dimension, we can say central region, north region, south region, or east region. For example, I'm not clearly sure what how many region to be. As an example, so I can set how many possibilities were there? 4. North, east, center, south. Four records were there. Then example, attribute gender. Suppose we want to the population of or in term of male and female or gender has the value M or F. M represent the male, F represent the female. So a table of the million of the population. So if you have a database for the million of the population, we can easily divide in term of two list of the million bit. One list for the male, another list for the female. This technique is very helpful. Later on I will discuss. This technique is very helpful for the case if we have the low cardinality. Moreover, I will discuss more feature. Let me wait for this bit so that it's clear when I will jump, when I do this one. As example is given to us as this table, okay, in which we have C2 C3 represent the customer, 7 customers were here, and these customer belongs to the region north, south, east and west. North, south, here. Then we have another column number 3 in term of rating. Rating means either they have the low rating, low, medium and high. These are the rating. What we need to do for each of the attribute or column, first we will make a index table. Indexing table for the region, as we saw here, and indexing table for the rating. Now again, for these 7 customers, we change the name that 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 just so that it will not the mix up. Then what we need to, how many distinct value do we have in this column? North, south, east and west. North, south, east and west. What we need to do for the customer number 1, we set the value for the customer number 1, set the value for n means we set the value 1, the rest will be 0. As we are familiar, bitmap only have 2 state, 1 and 0. What about the second one? Second customer, they belongs to south region. So for this, for the column of south, we will set the value. Third customer, he belongs to west region. For the third customer, it means we set the value w for 1, the rest will be 0. In the same way, we will compute for all of the 7 customers. What we have done, we make an index table for the region. Again, we need to make an index table for the rating. For the rating, how many distinct value to be a low, medium, high. It means for this index table, the length will be 3, low, medium and high. For the first customer, he has the rating of H. We set the value of H1, the rest will be 0. In the same way, we will complete fill up this table for the base table. What we need to do, for example, now we have, suppose we need to have the query that the find all of the customers that belongs to the region west and they have the rating of L, low rating. Suppose we have, so we design, we create the query, select customer. Select customer means that select this vegetable. Okay, then from vegetable will be used, this vegetable will be used. Then the what is the, here we have the list of the attribute, the list of the table, and here this is the conditional part for the to create the query. The conditional part is the region. This is our question. The region is W, and means and condition is another condition is the customer belongs to West region. Moreover, the customer also had the rating of low. We need to retrieve all of the customers. What we need to do? Let's come. Let's see. Here, over here, for example, first we will check what in the in this index table, the all of those rows in which we set the value W equal to 1. For this is W West. What we all of this value, we have all of this value, we will select these rows. These are the rows in which the customer number 3, customer number 4, customer number 6 and customer number 7, in which they these customer belongs to the region W. What about the another for the index, for the rating index? In the rating index we have the query that the rating should be low. We will select this one. These are the customers in which we have the set the value of low rating 1. What are those customers? Customer number 3 and customer 5 and 6 with web indexing. Now what we need to do, now we will match, because we have the end condition here. We will end condition, and end condition means we will select all of those highlighted rows. These are the rows, all of those highlighted rows which fulfill both the requirement, it means which will matching of, we need to select, because of our queries we need to retrieve the data of those customers which fulfill these two requirements. So what we have found, these are the highlighted rows, they will appear in both the table. So who are the customers? Customer number 3 and customer number 6, these are the customer who fulfill the requirement. Fulfill the requirement for both. Fulfill the requirement both. So the other answer, the what I need to mention, that the bitmap indexing technique, it is one of the technique what we require, especially they feel effective for the case if you have the low cardinality. Low cardinality means, since for the rating for the this we have only 4 distinct values. Here we have the 3 distinct values, or for example for the population of male female, or the 2 distinct values, or for the case of the corona we have the 2 distinct values, either the person we have the effective with the corona, does not have the corona, effective for only for those cases. If you have the very large distinct values, then this technique is not effective. Let me give, for example here we have only 3, suppose we have 7, 8, 9, 10 distinct values, then this technique is not effective for those cases. One more thing about the other technique in which if the data is in this technique, what we need to do, we need to create the indexing table for each of the column. It means if you have the database in which the database is frequently changing, then this technique is not effective. Or in other words, we can say the technique is effective for the case if the data is static, data type is static, something not frequently be changing. So these are the properties for the end. Let's talk about indexing OAP data. In the previous slide, we talk about indexing technique, then indexing online analytical processing data, or the joint indexes. How can we apply for the joint indexes? Let's talk about the what are the concepts associated with a joint indexes map. What is the joint index? The traditional indexes map the value of the list of the record of ID. Means what are the value? For example, value of the record ID. Means traditional technique in is the what are the, for example, what are the values for the one distinct value for the location. The distinct value for the location are state, city, region, etc. They are the distinct value. In the state, for example, Ulaya region, they are the distinct value. What we need to do, what are the, and for example, if we need to make the another table is about the item in the television, etc., Sony item, what we need, the value should, in the traditional approach, the value are mapped together, values are mapped together. Map the value of the list of the record ID. Then joint axis, what they do, these joint axis represented joint indexes represented by JR, in which these RID, record ID, RNS, RNS, they are the two words that we need to make the joint for R and the S, where R has the ID represented as the RID, have these values, and make the joint axis with the sign with the S. Then let me, yes, in the data warehouse, join index relate the value of the dimension. In the data warehouse, value, what is the value of dimension of a schema to the rows in the fact table? This is the fact table. These are the dimension table. What we need to do, we want to make the join indexes just like this one. The join indexes, what we want to make between them. Need to the value of, what are the value of dimension? They are the value of dimension. Then to the rows of the fact table, these are the rows of the fact table. In the way, so example fact table sale. This is a fact table sale. And two dimensions, city, for example item and the location. There are two dimensions, or because city and the product, there are dimensions were there. The interpretation is a joint index on the city. A join index on the city or the location maintain for each of the distinct city. It means here we maintain the list, maintain each distinct city, Makkah, Medina, Dammam, etc. A record RID, these are the, we will maintain our RID of the tuples recording the sale in the city. We will record them here. These are the tuples here. For example, here they maintain T57, T238, T459. We will maintain a list of the RID in the tuples according to the sales in the city. We will maintain them here as we did. Then joint indices can span multiple dimension. These joint indices can be a single dimension, can be multiple dimension. Then here it is maintained that the joint index can be spanned multiple dimension. It can be implemented as a bitmap index per dimension, or use the bit op for the multi dimension. If we have the for the single join, then we can use bitmap index, or we can use bit op for the multiple joins. Let the in the next slide we talk about the single dimension, the multiple joins. Let's see. Here we have the dimensions for their location, product, and the time. Moreover, we set the keys for the in the location as the city with the different cities in the location. Cities Makkah, Medina, and Quds. We set the keys 1, 2, 3. 1 for Makkah, 2 for Medina, 3 for Quds. Problem. What about the product? We set the values for 1, 2, 3. For the product PC, TV, and DVD. Moreover, in term of time, we set the values for the month 1, 2, 3, 4, or January, February, March, April, May, more than 1, 2, 3, 4. These represent the month, January, February, etc. What we need to do, that we want to make a join index. Here, as you can see, we have the low cardinality. Here, we have the low cardinality. If you have the 20, 30, 40, then this technique is not effective because less number of attributes were there, and because of low cardinality, then we can easily apply this, then we can easily maintain the join index. So what we do, we make a join index. What join index is here in the join index, what are the attributes were there? L key, location key, product key, and the time key. And what these are the quantities were there in the, these are the dimension table. They are all of the dimension table. dimension, these are the sales, sale indexing. Let me clear this one. These are the sale indexing. So for example, row ID number 4, it consists of, for the row, it consists of the 111. What is 111 represent? For the Makkah region, for the PC, and for the time of January. 111, where they sold the quantity 5. It means 5 PC for the month of January, they sold in the Makkah region. They sold in the Makkah region. Then, what about the, and this will be recorded in the row ID number 4. What about row ID number 5? Row ID number 121, what does the interpretation of 121 means? One, for the Makkah region and for television, in the month of January, they sold the quantity 7. In the same way, we maintain that in the joint indexing, in the fact table, these are the record they are stored. What then that means? What yes, in the same way, this all of them will be recorded. Now, the joint, if let's analyze for the joint indexing for the location and the product. Here we have the two dimension were there. Recall that we talk about the for the single dimension. Yes. Bit of will be used for the join multiple joints, and for the symbol per dimension we will take the bit frame index. Now what about this indexing, join indexing for the location product? Here because we only require to maintain the indexing for the location and the product, it means we the two columns will be required, city and the product. And these are the row ID in which this record has been stored. City 1, product 1. City 1 means city for the Makkah region, and for the product 1 means for the PC. Let's check about these for this one, city and product. Let me check. There we found 111. Yes, these are the one. For the 11, they are stored in the record ID 4. They are stored in the record ID 4. What about any other 11? Yes, if for other 11. One represent the city Makkah and the product represent the PC. So it means here what is recorded is 13. Recorded is 13. Let's talk about the 12. 12 represent the 12 represent the for the Makkah region and 2 represent television. Then what are the record? Then the row ID is 5. Row ID is 5. In the same way, it means we can in other words we can say we can maintain a joint indexing table for the multi-dimension. Advantage is very fast indexing. Because if you have a million, take the example for the Walmart. Walmart have all over the world their branches, and all over the world the branches, they need to retrieve the result very fast. For those cases, their joint indexing technique is very effective. Now, here the other two dimensions, not just about the single dimension. Again, for the same three dimension, location, time, product, then a joint index table is maintained as we saw in the previous slide. Here we have the location joint indexing just for the single dimension bit frame indexing. Then what about the city? It means we just need to have the indexing of this one. These are row ID 4, row ID 5, and 13, 14, 15. Row ID 4, 5, and 4, 5, 6. 13, 14, 15, they joint indexing table maintain the record here. What about 2? 2 means for the city of Medina. These are for the city of Medina. Row ID 7, 8, 9, 7, in this way we can easily maintain them. Now let's have efficient processing of OLAP queries. What are the processes until now we talk about? We talk about in terms of metallization, we talk about the full metallization, partial metallization, and no metallization. What are the tool we use in the OLAP? The tool used in the OLAP aggregation, navigation, selection, and the visualization. Now come back. Determine which operation should be performed on the available qubit. The point is here. It means for the efficient processing of the queries, we need to determine which operation for the qubit. Maybe we require the full metallization, maybe we require the partial metallization, maybe we require the no metallization. Moreover, which operation can be fulfilled my requirement to answer the for the query on the variable for the query. Maybe I required, maybe roll up operation will be good, roll drill down, etc. So in other words, we get transform, drill down, roll up, etc. Which operation will be used in the corresponding, then we need to get a corresponding SQL and what the corresponding OLAP different operation. For example, we can set that for the dice, a dice the, for the, you know, if we for the dice we require selection, the projection, selection and projection operation. What is selection? Selection the set of a table, set row of a table. What is the projection? Set column of a table. Determine to which metallized qubit. As I just mentioned that for the efficient processing, we need to find out for our query which metallization will be helpful. Full metallization, partial metallization, and the low metallization for relevant operation will be applied. Moreover, explore indexing structure and compressed versus dense array structure in the MLOP. MLOP. Here we need to be, for the efficient processing, we need to check either, for example, as you mentioned about the dense structure or the sparse. Dense, yes, for example, here, what are the dense array structure? What is dense array structure? They are having component of the part of the close compact together. If they are close compact, mean the component part choose close compact compact together. The point is here for the multi-dimensional OLAP. Need to mention that for efficient operation, we must know what are the operation will be required, what are the metallization will be required. Moreover, what are the structure that will be required to answer our query? The means here, just for the query, which operation will be appropriate, which technique will be appropriate, which metallization will be appropriate. This is to be checked. Now, data warehouse utilities. What first need to know what is data warehouse? Data warehouse, they retrieve the data for the entire organization. Moreover, the data can be of different form. Example is the data in the kingdom, they maybe maintain the Hijra calendar, whereas for the data for the Saudi airline in the USA, they maintain in the according to Georgian calendar. So then obviously something need to be done. So these are the five operations were there for the data warehouse utilities. The first one about data extraction, get the data from all of these sources, or in the because retrieve the data for the entire organization or multiple heterogeneous sources, they retrieve the data. First step. Second step is data cleaning. As I just mentioned, the data in the USA, the format is different as the data for the Saudi and the kingdom. The world boom, this is one of the examples. Second option, data cleaning. In the data cleaning, we will detect error in the data and rectify them when possible. First, we will detect what are the error over there. Once you identify the error, try to fix those error. Moreover, what we required, some process of amendment will be required. Sometimes we remove the data in the database that is incorrect. Some of the data, they are incorrect or duplication were there. These data need to be removed. Or sometimes the data is incomplete. Sometimes the data is in improper format. So these data all will be cleaned. Third step, data transformation. Convert the data from this host format to data warehouse format. As we retrieve the data from the entire organization, their form may be different. So we will convert the data from the host format to the data warehouse format. Example is, these data can be, for example, suppose enter the mobile number. How can different type of format possible? I am in the kingdom, I will direct at 056123456. Okay, then another possibility is if I am calling from the land, then what I need to do for the land number first we will enter the for the city for the enter the city code, then the land number. If I am calling from the outside, then if I directly dial the number 056 or mobile number or land number, it is not appropriate. First, I will enter the country code. in term of 0 in kingdom as plus 966. So all of them, they have the example for the transformation. Then once you transform the data, then we load the data. Load the data means first we can sort them, sorting for ascending, descending, etc. Make the summarization, then consolidate, integrate it together, and we have to compute different type of views. Recall we talk about different type of views, in the previous for the dissection, dice or the slice, etc. Then check the integrity, then build indices. Then in the loading, we will build indices and partition. In the different indices, we can maintain, for example, if the low cardinality, we can make the index table. Then the fourth one is about the refresh. If propagate the update from the source to the warehouse. Obviously, these data sometimes need to be updated. Propagate the update from the source data to the warehouse. Some data they are updated, then these data will be accumulated in the consolidated centralized repository of the data warehouse. This will be in term of refresh. Now let's talk about how to formulate the query. Multi-feature, for example, multi-feature cube compute complex query involving multi-dependent aggregate and the multiple granularities. This is one of the example in which how can we formulate the query in which we have the multiple granularities, multiple precision. And let's see with the example. We have the database in which we have the number of dimensions were there. Item, region, month, for example. Item, region, month. Then grouping by all of the formulation is, these are the, we need to make the SQL query is grouping all by all subset of item, region and month. We will group them in term of item, region and month. Find the maximum price in 2000. What we need to do for the year 2000, we need to find what is the maximum price or maximum price. Okay, then for each group, then these are the three groups were there. For each group, for the item, what is the maximum price, for the region, maximum price, for the month, and the total sale among all of the messages. Then what is the total sale among all of the maximum price tuples. If we have the query, then how do we formulate the query? We will formulate the query as select all of the attribute required to answer our query. Select item, region, month. Because item, let me clear this one. Item, region, month. Item, region, month. Then another attribute is we need to find the maximum price in 2000. What is the maximum price? Then sum of or total prices. Total price means sum of all of the prices. Sum of the which table? Then from which list of the table required, sales table required, fact table sales will be required to answer the query. What is the condition? Is we just require these two. That is the maximum sale and the sum of the sale for the year 2000 only. For the year only 2000. Then cube by means cube by is the operator in the DMQL. Just we have the group by. Then in term of cube by is item, region, month. Item, region, month for the item. Then so what is the condition? The condition is we want to formulate this query that the R price, that is the, in other words, we can say R dot sale should be maximum. If you forward me the these are R dot sale or means what it is, just sale. What is the maximum price for each of the group? Moreover, sale among all of the maximum prices. Then we find out what is the such that what is the first we identify the maximum prices. Then maximum prices. Then we can easily find the sum, make the summation. The point is here, yes, we have the advantage that we can, for the multi-granularities, we can formulate the query, we can easily answer, solve the problem. Now let's talk about it from OLAP, online article processing, to OLAM, online article mining. What is OLAP? OLAP is a tool that will be required for the for the data warehouse processing, the data warehouse operations. OLAP. The point is here, this OLAP can also be used for the OLAM, online analytical mining. Advantage is not only why do we require OLAP? OLAP is required so that we have the query, we can get this query, we can get or solve our problem for the decision making. These can also be used for the data mining. What is data mining? For the mining purpose only. For the mining, what is mining? Mining is if you want to explore, find the discoveries, find the patterns, find the find what is the correlation, find the association. Yes, OLAM can mining can also be applied. Let's see. So OLAM is online analytical mining. It is integration of OLAP with the mining techniques. As simple as we can say, OLAP operation, or it is a tool required for the data warehouse. If we will apply with the data mining technique, then our output with the OLAM. Here it is mentioned why OLAM, why do we require, what is the reason? Here let's see. High quality of data in the data warehouse, because in data warehouse we have already cleaned the data, transformed the data. Already inconsistency can they have removed, and some data we are in the proper format, there is no duplication. It means we have the high quality of the data. Then high quality data in data warehouse. Data warehouse contain the integrated consistency, clean data, transformed data. Then if something is been, then why don't we require to then which is available in the OLAP, then why don't we use for the OLAM for the mining purpose? So that's why available information process structure surrounded by database. Here in the OLAP we have some structure, some information process structure they are available for the data warehouse. For example, we can use ODBC. What is ODBC? Open database connectivity. It is an API for accessing database. They are available, we can apply them. Second one, OLEDB. OLEDB is the abbreviation for object linking and embedding database. It is an API designed by the Microsoft company. In it allowed accessing of the data from variety of the sources in a some uniform manner, very efficient manner. Moreover, we also the web accessing technologies, they are available. Service facilities, they are available. Moreover, we have some reporting tool, they are available in the OLAP. Another reason, so it means something, the data is so good, is a processing structure there available, why don't we use for the OLM for the mining purpose? Mining. Then OLAP based exploratory data analysis. We have the OLAP based exploratory database mining with the drilling. We know we have the drill up, drill down, etc. We have provision were there. We have the visualization were there, dicing were there, slicing were there, pivoting were there. Then good, another good reason. Online selection of the data mining function. Integration is swapping of multiple mining function algorithm and task algorithm and task. The point is here, I will give simple example, then it is more clear to you. Couple of weeks ago, three or four weeks ago, WhatsApp, they changed the privacy and it is protest all over the world. Have you ever explored or find out and think why the WhatsApp, Messenger, Facebook, they provide service? Why do they provide the free of mind? Did they ask you to money? No, they don't ask you to the money. Then how do they pay the salary for the cost of the infrastructure? Actually, what they do, they sell your information. They apply the data mining technique on you, on your data. on data and they sell this information to the private companies who require the targeted customers. What they do? Apply the data mining technique or mining. They will apply mine for the huge database for the billion of the people of the record. For them, what they do? Database is there for the WhatsApp. They want to sell these data, private information. Then apply the mining technique so that private companies can find the targeted customers. So right now, note one thing. Today, infrastructure have the value or cost, or the we can say value of the infrastructure is less as compared to the value of the data. And value of data means mining technique, etc. Mine something, mining, find the discovery, find the pattern, etc. So we'll stop right now, inshallah, we'll continue. So thanks everyone, thank you very much. Now you may leave the session.